here tonight is that you all walk away and you go home and you encourage at least one other person, two other people, family, friends, to go vote. Each voice counts. I know that most, it's the majority in this area that don't vote, isn't it? The majority of people here have not voted. So you're relying, we are relying on the voices, on the people, on the votes of those who usually do not vote. Encourage people. We know that all of you, except probably that Free Palestine one, but everyone else here is voting for Tommy. But you need to go home and you need to be the voice. You need to encourage at least one, two, three, four other people to do the same. What do you reckon, Tom? Are we ready? Alright, so I know you're all here to see the man of the hour, the man that's gonna take this European, the man that's gonna make Brexit happen accidentally. Because the moment Tommy walks into that parliament, Brexit is on! Tommy Robinson!
I want to thank you for coming to the rain.
Tommy Robinson!
I've spent today meeting with the police. Meeting with the police because last night, anyone who's seen our vehicle we've been using, this is a different vehicle because last night our vehicle was attacked with bricks.
Yeah.
And the windows were smashed. And up until about 3 hours ago, we didn't have a PA system. I was running around Manchester Arndale Centre trying to buy a megaphone in Sports Direct. That's what I was doing today. I was thinking, if we haven't got a megaphone, I thought I'd just have to turn up and shout. But we managed to get this sorted. So I met with the police today. And I think it's good that people witness the way the law is not implemented equally for all people. I went to a candidate meeting with all the other MEPs yesterday and I asked the police officer if any other MEP or potential MEP in this room is physically assaulted, people will be arrested, won't they? If any other MP, you've all seen it before, if anyone wrote anything, I have handed in today, and I don't, and the sad thing is, I expect no arrest to be made. I have handed in today, and Mum, if you're watching, because my mum keeps ringing me up, saying, be safe. I'm reading, so Tommy Robinson's coming to my town on the 18th, I can't wait to get arrested trying to stab him. That's brutal. And the sad thing is, again, I found out each one of these people's names and addresses. I know where they all live. I've got people inciting murder. These are crimes, okay? Any other candidate, even the fact last night our vehicle was smashed with bricks and the window smashed. And unfortunately, the driver that we were using is too scared to drive for us now. Any other candidate, this would be on national news. Instead, you've all seen how they spin the stories. Look what happened in Warrington. In Warrington, you've seen it. We were harassed. We were attacked multiple times. But the media know this. They've watched the same videos that you've watched. They've seen the Muslim agitator continually being aggressive. Yet the media spin. And the way they tell the story that his milkshake slipped, that we confronted him aggressively. Who watched the Jeremy Vine show? The Jeremy Vine show, they stood on TV and said that I aggressively confronted him. That does not happen. There's no evidence to that at all. This is the media, the establishment, the lies. And they don't just do that whilst at the minute they're doing it to me. They generally do it to us. They generally label every single one of you standing here today. You've been labelled as far right, as extreme. Because what? Because what? Yeah, because what? if I spoke in a different way and I had a different background and I went to a certain school, I'd be sitting on question time.
Yeah.
I'd be probably, I would. Everything I say, there's nothing I say that's different to what Douglas Murray says. Douglas Murray's not called a racist or an extremist or far right. It's a class system. It's a class system. And what I'm asking all of you, and if we can build this, I want the 23rd of May not to be, I said it last night, not to be a protest, but to be the start. The start of us galvanising. The start of us and our communities sending them a message, not just sending the UK a message, because the world will feel the earthquake. I hope that the Northwest has the highest percentage of vote for me and against me. But I hope we're politicised in 4 weeks, because that's how long we've had. I wish I'd have had 6 months knowing I was going to stand for election. And I'd love to win. I believe I will win, but I need your help to do so. And on the 23rd, I send so much shock. But the reason why it's so important and momentum is so important is, as I've said, I want this to be the start. I don't want this to be about this election, simply about the European elections. In fact, the European elections is complete nonsense. The whole thing's a facade. The money they get paid, the power they have, it's nothing. Yeah. It is nothing. But if this works, if we can do it, then it will galvanise, it will electrify, and we will show that we can do it. And then we can spread it. So whilst it's the Northwest now, the whole country is ready. And I know it's ready, because every town and city I go into, every person I meet, do you know what I understand? Is I'm passionate about it, but I see your passion. I see your passion, how much you care. And everywhere I go, I don't walk through a shopping centre, I don't get out of the petrol station, I don't go into KFC without people not just saying, all right, Tommy, but saying, come on, we're with you. And everyone's feeling it. And I said before, for 10 years we've faced opposition. For 10 years I've faced opposition. For all the years since anyone's been involved, we've all faced opposition. And there's something they just don't get. They do not get it. No matter what they throw at it, no matter what they throw at it, no matter what they offer us, no matter the opposition, there is nothing that they can do to stop what has started. We've been saying there is a swing from left to right. What has been happening? That's their friends over there. At least they're being peaceful. At least they're being peaceful. Brexit. Now this one's for you. This one's for all you lot. And this one's for the politicians who are watching. I've been saying since I started giving speeches, there is a swing that's happening from left to right. And there is no government, there is no police force, there is no money or no organisation that can stop it. We've witnessed it across Europe. We have stood for too long. We've watched electoral successes. I get excited when there is an election in other countries. When there was the election in Italy, I get excited looking at La Liga. I looked at where La Liga come from. They went from 4% to 24% in 4 years. We're getting excited about that. I get excited about Sweden. I get excited about Holland's elections. It's time for us to get excited. On the 23rd of May, it's our moment to get excited to see the world.